today's Hollywood news, jaws are still dropped in disbelief as Super Bowl superstar Rafael Barrows announced his engagement to aging media star Keira Jeffries. Barrows' fiance made headlines earlier this month as the queen of wardrobe malfunctions at the West Coast Music Awards. Hollywood critics are questioning whether this is really true love
or just a last-minute grab for headlines from Miss Jeffries. Miss Jeffries could not be reached for comment. It is rumored that she may be in fashion
Trolls. Hello?
Chuck, where are you?
If I wanted you to know, I would have told you, Chuck.
This is great. Who thought that Jock would propose? Keira, you are trending huge.
You think I know that?
You cannot disappear.
You want to bet on it? Want to get away from it all? Yes, yes, I do.
Thank you for coming, Jim.
I'll be coming out in a moment.
Did anyone recognize him?
No. To them, he was just
another young black thug. I suppose I should be glad they didn't shoot him.
Naomi.
What's the charge?
Possession with intent to sell.
Drugs. Evan had drugs.
Yes. Look, it's his first offense, and I got him out. But Naomi, if this had happened next week when he turns 18, we'd be looking at something that not even a Holloway name would be able to fix.
Evan has early acceptance to Yale. If this gets out...
Look, my suggestion... Take him somewhere for a few days. Keep him out of the public eye while I clear this up with the DA.
Do what you can.
Hi, Grandma.
Welcome. I want to thank you all for joining us this morning in the celebration of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm so glad he's back. It's his first sermon since their little girl passed.
I also want to thank you for the love and support that you've offered my wife and I during our period of grief and healing. Survival in this world is about faith. Every single day is about faith. Mm-hmm. It is said that faith is the silver... That faith is the silver thread, it is the pearl. Abby? Don't leave. Abby, don't leave.
Clinton.
People, it's time for some changes.
Are those pelicans?
Oh, how Abby would have loved this.
It's too cold on this side.
Is Abby your daughter? How old is she?
Six. She was six. Abby passed away 6 months ago. Leukemia.
I'm so sorry, my dear.
Thank you. My husband and I... Healing is hard.
People! It's time for some changes. People!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Île du Soleil, or Island of the Sun, as we non-French speakers like to call it. My name is Ray Tepper, and it is my job to make sure you are all safe and comfortable. Let's find out who we have with us today. Mr. and Mrs. Clinton Hines.
That's Reverend and Mrs. Hines.
Sorry, my bad. Welcome, Reverend. Ms. Alice Randolph. Ms. Alice Randolph?
No, that's my grandmother, Naomi Holloway, and I'm Evan Holloway.
All right, Holloway's I got. Are you Alice Randolph?
Yes, that's me.
Very good, thank you. Everyone, it is now time to start your vacation.
Yes, thank you so much.
Right this way.
Evan, wait for me. How absolutely lovely.
Oh,
these plants. So much life. This is great.
Oh, what a marvelous room. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to Isle du Soleil.
Honey, look at this place.
I'm Eric Nordholm, and this is my beautiful wife, Laura Cook Nordholm, and we are the owners and operators of the Isle du Soleil Resort. I manage the business end, but the ambiance, well, it's all Laura.
Oh, it's simply beautiful here.
Thank you. This property has been in my family for over 300 years.
300 years?
Yes. Each guest room is individually designed, and we have a separate bungalow for guests who require privacy.
That's me.
I'll fight you for it. I'm just joking. LOL.
Okay, walk with me. I'll show you the grounds.
300 years.
300 years.
Oh, my goodness.
Everything we eat is from the island. The actual site of the resort is the land that once belonged to a root priestess, and it's said to be imbued with healing powers. Please help yourselves. We have shrimp fried in a rice flour batter. We have plantains with a pink sea salt.
Can I just get a burger and fries?
Evan?
What? I'm on vacation, right?
That's okay, we'll cook him a burger. We got veggie, we got chicken, even goat.
My grandson will eat what is being served, or he can wait until dinner.
Three cheers for child abuse.
Well, luckily, you aren't a child.
You know what, I think I'm gonna forage for my lunch. Maybe I'll find some poison berries.
Don't stain your shirt.
Teenagers. We have one ourselves. I'm sure we can exchange war stories.
Thank you.
May I get you some tea?
Oh, gosh, yes. Tea would be glorious.
Let me just go pick the lime.
Are you making lime leaf tea?
You know it?
Yes, I actually do.
Oh, wow. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Just say when.
Oh, yeah, don't be shy.
Yeah? All right.
Oh, load it up.
Let's eat over there, Clinton. Oh, I can't get enough of this view.
I think I'm gonna go in and find the room. Lay down. I need a nap.
You can stop hiding now.
How'd you know I was here?
The birds told me. Every single step you made through the forest, you scared the birds, and they flew off ahead. You knew exactly where you were at all times.
So what are you doing, some kind of hoodoo?
It's a Gullah blessing. The sage purifies my intention, and my prayer gives thanks and opens up the four directions.
So, like, what are you singing? What does that mean?
It means healing place.
Okay, right. If you say so.
Freya Cook Nordum. Nice to meet you.
Evan. Evan Holloway.
Okay.
What?
Nothing. You just said that all, like, Bond. James Bond. Like I'm supposed to recognize you or something?
Well, I am the grandson of Senator Wilson Holloway.
Oh, cool. He was amazing. He's retired now, right?
Actually, he's dead.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, Evan Holloway. Why are you here?
Vacation?
Yeah, okay.
What, are you calling me a liar?
No, it's just, you wouldn't be the first guest we've had who's running from something. You know, this island tends to attract the wounded birds. Come on. Let's get you back to the resort. My parents like to call Isle du Soleil, but I call it Runaway Island.
What if I don't want to go back just yet?
Well, you also wouldn't be the first guest to be eaten by gators. Come on, city boy.
To your liking?
Oh, yes, it's lovely, thank you, but it's bringing back memories I'm not sure I want remembered.
It's not the tea. It's the island. It has that effect on people.
Pardon me.
Where you been? Could have used your help when the guest arrived.
I was actually helping one of them. I found him prowling around the forest.
Oh, well, thank God you found him before he fell into a mudslide.
I know, right? I'm gonna go clean up and come back and help you guys with dinner.
Hold on. Did you get a chance to look at those college acceptance letters that I left on your desk?
No need.
And why not?
So I'm not going to any college.
Freya, we've talked about this. You cannot stay here forever. Baby, you have Smith, Stanford, Spelman, and Columbia all waiting to hear back from you.
Freya, if you're worried about the money, it's
I'm not worried about anything. I just don't need to go anywhere. Everything I need to learn is right here. That's all. See you guys later.
Hmm.
is all your fault.
And how am I to blame for her stubbornness? This is clearly from your side of the gene pool.
I'm tired of being mean, Mommy, okay? You're up from here on out.
I got it.
You'd better. We don't have much time. These colleges, they're not going to wait forever to hear. They'll move on.
Ooh.
Mr. Nordholm.
Mm-hmm.
I need to finish cooking dinner.
Mm-hmm. Mrs. Nordholm, how about we just skip straight to dessert?
Later, I promise.
Your pinky promise?
Are we six?
You got this mean mommy thing down cold.
Get out.
Cold!
How old is this house? It's magnificent.
You know, it's part of the old summer house. It actually predates the plantation.
So when do we get to see that?
The plantation? I'm afraid that's gone. The slave cemetery is all that's left. And you can't go there.
So much for the one cool thing to do here.
Sorry I'm late. Hi.
Yeah, that's a really beautiful dress.
Thank you.
It's much nicer than the one you wore to the music awards.
That's who you are, with the wardrobe mouth. Did you just pinch me? Like, who still does that?
Sorry, you must have me confused with somebody else. I'm just Mary. Mary Hayes.
You checked in as Alice Randolph.
Fine. It's not Hayes Murphy or Randolph. It's Jeffries. I'm Kira Jeffries.
You know, my dear, I don't actually care who you are, but the food is getting cold, and I do care about that.
Yes, Mr. Hines, I understand that you're a minister. Will you please do us the honor in leading us in grace?
If it's all the same to you, I would like to defer to the other fine men and women at the table.
Oh, come on, Clinton.
I said no. Why can't that be enough?
Thank you, God, for everyone and everything. Amen.
And that will cover it.
Excuse me.
I'm so sorry.
No apology needed. I'm sorry to upset him.
Man, this soup is amazing.
Mm-hmm. It's an old island recipe. Sheet crab bisque.
She crab, he crab, what's the difference?
Well, it's called that because it's made from pregnant crabs and their babies.
That's a bit too much information.
Mm. Oh, crap.
Oh, whoa. Get away. Ew, get away. What?
So horrible.
What?
Not you, baby. The dinner, it couldn't have been any worse.
You could have barfed into the soup.
Not that, but that was pretty bad.
Yeah, it was.
But what was worse was their sadness. All those people, each one, they're just all so sad and miserable. I've never seen a sadder bunch in my life. And you know, we get some pretty wounded people here.
All right. Say it.
We gotta help these people, Eric. This is a place for healing and helping others. All the turn down service and lobster bisque and spa massages in the world aren't gonna do a thing for these folks.
So why give it to them?
What?
Come here. Now what if we take all their resort expectations and toss them?
They'd freak out.
Or
I married a genius.
I'm glad you finally left him for me.
Thank you, honey.
Did you sleep well?
Not too bad. Thank
you. Lovely.
How about yourself?
Quite well. Thank you so much.
Oh. Hi.
Good morning.
Did I miss breakfast?
No, I haven't seen anyone yet.
Breakfast bell, but no breakfast. Story of my life.
Ah, here we go.
Oh, good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Oh, great.
I was hoping for an omelet.
Well, do you know how to make an omelet?
No, not really. Why are you asking me?
Well, my parents are both sick. Anyway, they're in bed till they get better. So if you guys want to eat, I'm gonna have to ask you to pitch in and help.
Is there something else here? Like cereal or something?
Yeah, we have cereal. But if you want milk with that, you're gonna have to go down to the goat.
She did not just say that.
Oh, yes, she did.
And if you want more fruit, you're gonna have to pick it. And if you want chicken...
All right, just stop right there. Yeah, thanks.
Okay, it's not for forever. When the boat comes, he'll bring fresh supplies. But for the next few days, I need people who can cook. Volunteers. Anyone? Good. Anyone to help Naomi? Oh, good. Great.
Oh.
Okay. Anyone know how to fish?
Well, thank God they still had champagne.
Yes.
I'm not going in there.
You want to eat? Hello, my lovelies.
You okay?
I'm fine.
You sure?
Won't talk and scare away the fish.
Okay. Come on. Yeah, yeah. Watch me. Okay, it's just all in the wrist.
Pretty good at that for a city boy.
Well, I've been doing this for a long time. My grandpa owned a spot in the country right on the pond.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this man was a senator, most dignified guy you ever saw, but on the weekends, you know, he'd take off his shoes, roll up his pants, and fish, work in the garden, get dirty, what have you. Man, you've never seen my grandma do anything like that. I don't think I've ever even seen her toes. She's about as uptight as they come.
Well, you won't have to worry about things like Google hits once you marry that nice-looking young man.
Yeah, well, I don't think that's gonna happen.
Is that why you're hiding out here?
You know, ever since I was a baby, my grandmother's been dressing me up in a suit and tie just so I can make a good impression. so she could say I was following in my grandfather's footsteps. But what about my footsteps?
Yeah, what about your footsteps?
Exactly.
What I'm saying, what about your footsteps? What's your plan? Because not wanting to be your grandfather, that's fine, but that's not a plan. Wanting to be a rebel? Well, that's fine too, but that's not a plan either.
So what are you, a counselor and a preacher?
Honestly, man, I don't know what I am.
Now they'll bite.
Oh, what?
You got them dogs in there, now they gonna bite.
How did you two meet?
Our publicist set it up. Said it would be good for our images.
They do that now? Publicists?
Yeah. How else do you think famous people meet?
Well, that seems rather efficient.
It's horrible. And if you're both popular with the public, next thing you know, you're engaged to be married and you're thinking you're in love because, well, that's what the general public is saying you are. God, this was not supposed to happen. This was just supposed to be a media stunt for us both, not some thing with feelings involved. There are never any feelings involved.
Well, apparently there are now.
You don't have to pretend to understand for my benefit. My life is nothing like yours.
Don't underestimate life in DC politics, dear. Either you love this boy or you don't. Either way, you just can't keep hiding out here. Decide, then go handle your business, black woman.
Hey, whoa, you okay?
I've been feeling a little under lately. Maybe I have a pinch of what your parents have. Hopefully I didn't give it to them.
Yeah, truly was, man. It wasn't for me, and right. I'm hungry, guys. Right. So.
Did you have a good day today, Clinton?
Yeah.
Wanna go down to the beach? It's pretty there, and
Vonda, I'm you go, baby. No, I'm tired. I'm gonna go and I'm gonna go take a nap. Yeah, you go.
Clinton.
What?
Smells good.
Wash it.
You're burned.
I'm fine.
There's a first aid kit around here somewhere.
I said I'm fine, Pearlie.
What'd you call me?
Pearlie. I called you Pearlie. You remember, don't you?
I can't do this. What are you doing?
What are you doing?
I'm on a trip with my grandson. The last thing I expect is to look up and find you.
Oh, my God.
You are still as lovely as you always were.
And
aren't you supposed to be in the army? Aren't you some big muckety-muck in the army?
Muckety-muck? Well, yes. I was in the army. I was an officer. But then I left and I came here. I'm really sorry. I heard about your husband.
Thank you.
I never married. I just never expected I'd ever see you again.
We were so young.
Yeah, we were. But what do we do now?
Get up.
For what? Why?
Come on, we're gonna go get berries.
Girl, I'm out here suffering from starvation. Matter of fact, get me some with some whipped cream, a double cheeseburger and a pickle, and some broccoli. I'll even eat broccoli.
No. Come you... on.
All right. Slow down. Hey, why are you running? No, this whole Sheena, Queen of the Jungle thing would usually be kind of hot, but I'm getting bit by everything on this island with more than four legs.
Oh, quit being such a baby. God, man. These are my ancestors.
This is a slave cemetery.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Come on. I want to show you something else.
Whoa.
I know. This tree stood on the grounds of what was once a plantation. It was called La Maison Bleue.
Cool, so you're like really connected to this place.
Oh, yeah. Now, this is me, Evan. This is my home. This is my home. And my parents. They want me to leave here and go to college?
Let me guess, you don't want to go.
No. Why would I want to? You know, what's out there for me?
Man, I wish I had that problem. My grandmother is the micromanaged queen. I can't breathe around that woman. Sometimes I gotta just wild out to show I'm human, you know, show I'm an individual.
So is that why you're here?
Yeah.
What'd you do?
I got busted with a couple ounces on me.
It's serious.
I know. This is way different than all the other stuff.
There's more?
Yeah, I kept it pretty busy.
Well, what about your mother and father?
Father? Your guess is about as good as mine. My mother has some drug issues, and my grandparents took me away from her.
You took it from your mom? I'm sorry. Do you at least stay in contact with her?
No. No, I never knew her. You know, it kind of sounds weird, but I really miss someone I never knew.
That's not weird. The boat.
That's a book.
Let's go. Come on.
Okay.
Let me pack my stuff.
There's no time. We have to go now.
No. No. No, Mother Nature. These are my Jimmy Choo's. Get your own. Oh.
He's gone.
Oh. Hi, I'm looking for Kira Jeffries.
I'm sorry, Mr. Barrows, but we're all full. No, next time it'd be advisable to make a reservation.
Will you stop harassing this man? He's a Super Bowl guy. Hey, I'm a big fan, bro.
Look. Kira Jeffries is here, right?
Sure is.
I mean, you can't give out that kind of information.
I just did. Look, we're all full for the week, but I do have a small overflow space. It's not as nice, but it puts a roof over your head.
Okay, look, I'll take it.
Okay. Just sign here.
Okay. Keys, please.
Oh, you don't need a key. Enjoy your stay.
Is this how we treat guests?
Isn't he?
Oh.
Mm-hmm. What do you think, Mrs. Hines?
I'm thinking I'm a married woman, Mrs. Holloway.
Yes, you're married, but you're not dead. Towel, young man.
What?
Yeah, great to see you too.
Why are you here, Raphael?
I'm here for you. Why else?
Oh, come on.
Look, I'm confused. Now, I thought things were good between you and I, and then you suddenly up and disappear. You won't return my calls? I don't know
what... Most people would have picked up on the hint.
Kira, when you disappeared, I hired a whole army of detectives to find you. I won't even go into what it's been like living in that tent. I came here because I was worried about you. Because I care.
I have no interest in becoming your wife.
You don't mean that.
I do. You knew what this was when you got into it.
It's not my fault if you got confused and you developed feelings for me.
Maybe you just need to think about this.
There's nothing to think about. This isn't about you. This is about me. Maybe your reps should have explained that to you before they put you in my line of fire.
The boat's not coming back until Monday. You stuck here with me until then.
Guilty hoarding all of this food. Are they gonna be okay? What if they're not okay, Eric?
Well, that was your idea.
No, it wasn't. It was your idea.
No, it was your idea.
It was yours.
No, I'm quite certain that it was yours, baby.
It was fully your idea.
It was your idea.
No, it wasn't.
Ow. It was your idea.
No, it wasn't.
No, it was yours.
No, it was yours.
Hi.
Where have you been? Why haven't you checked in?
Mom, I've been up to my elbows trying to run this place like you asked me to. Right?
Okay, well talk, Pigeon. What's happening out there? I've been going nuts hiding in here. Tell me everything. What?
Well, it seems to be working. I mean, they're talking to each other, going out, doing things, even Reverend Hines.
That's great. Isn't that great, Eric?
Yeah, my idea worked.
Yeah, but these are really nice people, and I'm not sure how cool it is to manipulate them like this.
No, sweetheart. These people are changing and growing on their own. We're just giving them the room to be who they really are.
Well, I'm glad you could do that for them. Some of us here are forced to be who you insist we are.
Here we go.
Oh, do I detect that we're venturing into the land of Freya Picker College?
Okay, look. I have to go, okay? I have a Jock in the Overflow dinner to cook. Oh, and Miss Vonda thinks she has what you have. What would that be? Manipulitis?
Did she say a jock?
What is this?
Sweet potato wine. I make it myself.
Oh, Lord. Oh. Oh, God.
That good, huh?
What do you remember about me, Raymond?
Well, you were very pretty. And stuck up. I mean, you know, it's a small wonder that when you walked around with your nose stuck up in the air that you didn't drown when it rained.
Thank you.
You're also very, very smart.
Yeah. Maybe too smart, huh?
Were you happy?
Wilson was a difficult man to live with. But I loved him, yes. Wasn't much room in his life, his work, for me or for... It was better after Melanie was born. Now... Mel is our daughter. But Mel just wasn't the kind of daughter
respected. She was bold and rebellious and free-spirited. She's just... There was no room in our family for her voice, for her laughter, for... We kept trying to change her. The more we tried, the more she fought. Till... Oh, Raymond. You don't know pain until you've seen your baby with a needle sticking out of her arm.
Your hands are cold. Thanks for listening.
Well, you trusted me to hear you, and that means an awful lot to me. Good night, Pearlie.
Raymond.
Yeah.
Come inside.
Are you sure?
I'm a little bit drunk. You smell really good.
Where have you been?
Out.
Out where?
Walking.
All day?
Yes, all day.
Clinton, we need to talk.
Rhonda, I'm tired. Let's just talk in the morning.
This can't wait. Every day I avoid having this conversation with you is another day we grow further apart.
Fonda, I...
No. We talk now. Why don't you want to be around me, Clinton?
Maybe that's not it.
It is. Detroit's one thing. You have parishioners to visit, church business to attend to, but we're on an island, Clinton. And you still find a way to avoid me. So, it's not because you're busy. It's obvious you don't want to be around me.
Yes.
Why?
I just need to be alone.
You need to be alone. You go into another room and you shut the door. You tell me that you need time to yourself. You don't surgically cut me out of your life and make me feel like I've done something wrong.
What do you understand?
What don't I understand, Clinton? I don't understand what it's like to lose a child. I don't understand getting up every morning and making a bowl of cereal knowing damn well there's not going to be anyone there to eat it. I don't understand how it feels to look at my daughter's body, my only child, and put makeup on her face for her funeral. Please, you tell me what it is I don't understand. No, no, you got to stay here and you are going to talk to me.
Move.
No.
Move, Vonda.
No!
Damn it, woman, get out of the way!
The only way I'm moving is if you make me. And I don't think that's in you.
I'm so sorry. I'm just not ready.
I love you. I want our marriage to survive this, but we can't grieve separately. We've got to find our way out of this together. This is about us.
I don't believe.
Believe.
I don't believe in God anymore. The morning before Abby passed, I went to the hospital chapel in Bundy. I prayed. I prayed that the Lord would take me. I prayed that he would take my life and not my baby girl. And he didn't. When the Lord is supposed to be loving and merciful. Where's the love in that? Where's the mercy? And then I had to go sit in the church with those people at her funeral and listen to them talk about God's plan for us. And all I could think about was I've been betrayed. God betrayed me. He loved me. I walked the walk. I talked the talk. For what? And we waited so long to have a baby. And for what? To lose her? What is the plan? No, and then I had to go in front of the congregation, in front of the church, and I had to preach the word of God. And I felt like a fool, like a con man, like a fraud. I was standing there in front of those people that I was selling them a whole bill of goods. Then if they lived their life right, there would be rewarded with riches. Where's my riches, Father? Where's my reward? Abby.
God, I need you. I need you now.
You look beautiful this morning.
Yeah, I'll take that.
Thank you, sweetheart. Hey,
Mom. Good morning, Booger.
Look who's back. Good morning.
Hey, good morning.
Are you feeling better, dear?
I am. I'm fine. Thank you. And look at you. You're positively glowing.
Oh, thank you. It must be the sea air.
Ah.
Ravenous.
I could smell those waffles all the way from my tent.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, yes, it is. A wonderful morning, in fact.
Thank you. Morning.
Good morning. Freya told me you weren't feeling too well. I have some healing teas in my pantry. May I show them to you?
Yes, please.
Tell me when.
A little more. Perfect. I have some wild mint. Dried last season. That's always good.
My husband,
He's lost his faith.
Well, I don't have a tea for that. I'm not religious, but I've always felt that faith is one of those things that even if you felt you've lost it, it never loses you. Oh.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, someone's sitting here.
Well, who kidnapped Kira?
That Kira is retired. I can't be a media marble with no Wi-Fi, can I? Pass the X.
They're wonderful.
I love the way you look.
Thank you.
Let me help you where I can. What's bothering you?
Headache, digestion.
I don't feel bad all day. It's just when I wake up, my head feels light. I get flashes of fever and I feel like throwing up. Is that what you had?
Yeah. 18 years ago.
Good morning, honey. You look rested.
Do I? Well, not.
Didn't sleep well?
It's hard to sleep at all with the image of you pawing all over my grandmother on replay in my head.
Evan?
You know, you really have me going with all that talk about sacrifice, upholding the sacred Holloway name, and the first chance you get, you're out here going native, knocking knees with the hired help.
That's enough. You apologize to your grandmother.
Now kiss my ass,
son. I'll man. Kick your ass, you little...
Hey, get over here. Hey, give me something.
Hey. Everybody relax, okay? Take a deep breath and calm down, okay?
Excuse me, everyone.
My room, now.
Me? How could you?
I have tried. God knows I have tried. I have tried to raise you to be a responsible young man, and all I have in return is a spoiled, selfish little egotist.
Well, it looks like you weren't cut out for parenting now, huh? This is the second generation you failed. Maybe you shouldn't have stolen me from my mother.
Is that it? Is that your solution to everything?
Look, you didn't have the right, okay? My mother would have raised me just fine.
No, she wouldn't. She was an addict, Evan.
No, no, no. Lots of people are addicts. You don't just get to steal their children away from them.
I didn't steal you.
That's a lie.
After you were born, your mother walked right out of that hospital to get her next fix. I never once looked back. You want to blame someone for all of your problems, then fine. You blame her. She is the one that abandoned you. And I did what she actually didn't do for you. And all you have now is just, you're hard-headed. You are spoiled, rude, and unappreciative. You are just like Melanie. You are just like your mother. No, Evan, Evan, oh, please. Evan, I'm sorry. Evan, I'm sorry.
Plastic story. These are the words I speak with my mouth. I love you too. Look at me, what can I do? These
all the words I speak in my mouth, and they're coming out. Ooh, they're coming out. I speak a love language passed through history. Harry behind.
Hey.
This is hard for you, isn't it?
She looked just like Vonda. Mm. My baby girl. Every time I look at my wife, it just tears me up all over again.
You love them both, right?
Baby, you handle things really well, Freya. I'm proud of you.
Thanks, Mom.
So, you need to pick a college today. No more procrastination.
I thought we already resolved this.
No, we haven't.
You are trying to get rid of me.
I'm not, Freya.
Why don't you just come out and say, get the hell out?
You will not speak to me like that, young lady.
You want me gone? Fine. I'm gone.
Freya! Freya!
What's going on?
I had a fight with Freya.
What about college?
Yes.
I thought we were gonna let me handle that.
You weren't handling it, Eric.
Hey, I think I know where she might be.
Can we talk?
Yeah.
You know the thing that most attracted me to you?
What?
You were a deacon back then. It was your first sermon. You were so passionate. Your energy exploded from that pulpit and washed over the entire congregation. My heart literally stopped. I knew in that moment you were someone I could never ignore. You still have that intensity. That's why I think this has been so difficult for you. You think you're the only one of us that abandoned their faith, but I question mine as well. Abby's death cut me to the core of my soul. But one thing brought me back. I absolutely had to believe that I would see her again. That's the only thing that gets me out of the bed in the morning, that and how much I still love you. You want to know how I know God is real, Clinton? This is how I know. Only God can end a life. But only God can make one.
Vonda.
Abby's gone, baby. But her sister or brother is waiting for you to show up.
What if I can't find
Mom? You can. And you will. Because that's the kind of man you are. It doesn't matter what else you do in this world, Clinton.
Can we talk?
Yes, of course.
She didn't want me.
Don't say that.
How could I not?
Because if your mother hadn't been so painfully, tragically ill, she would have loved you. You're the best of her. You are all of the things that were so good about her. She would have loved you like I love you.
Where is my mother? Like, is she still alive?
I don't know. That's why when Jim said that you were dealing drugs, I just saw the whole thing being replayed.
What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about, Evan, the marijuana.
That, look, it wasn't even my grandma.
What do you mean it wasn't yours?
There's this guy, Mark Whitten, from school. When we got pulled over, I said it was mine because I knew he'd lose his scholarship. I knew you could get me out of it.
Evan Holloway. That was idiotic, foolhardy, and presumptuous. You mean you're not using drugs?
No, I'm sorry, Grandma. I know I haven't made this easy.
No, young man, you have not.
Oh. Truce?
Truce.
I love you, Grandma, but I really do. I swear.
So is this part where you yell at me?
Why would I yell at you? You don't want to leave your home. I get it.
And why are you and Dad pressuring me to leave?
Honey, nothing would make me happier than to have you here with us forever. I don't want you to leave, ever. But that would be selfish of me. You think this is the first time I'm having this conversation? The last time was with my parents. And I was sitting right where you are. I, however, didn't handle it with the grace that you have. There was a whole lot of I hate yous involved. But they were right, Frey. I needed to go out and see the world and experience what it had to offer me. And because of that, I met a man who loves me. and whom I love. And together, we have this incredible daughter, whom we've always considered our special gift. Growing up, it's going out and touching others' lives and changing them. And when or if you're ready, you'll always have a home to return to. I love you. Can we get down from here? Because Mama don't weigh what she did when she was 17. So.
What are you afraid of?
Truth? This, you, is too real.
And that's a bad thing?
God, are you serious? Nothing in my life is real. The Kira, you know, that's just what I tell the rest of the world. It's not the real me. You don't know the real me. And this fake me, well, she's about to reach her expiration date. No one wants to see a 30-something without any underwear on. Run away, Raphael. You don't want anything to do with this.
Maybe you don't need the whole world to love you. Just one person. One person that will make you the center of his world. Kira, can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Why did you say yes?
You treated me differently. Not like I was just a name. And when I was around you, I felt good about myself. And I appreciate you for that. Okay, now my turn.
Okay.
Why? Why did you ask me to marry you?
Honestly, at first, I thought you were just another dull, pretentious, rich girl.
Okay.
And then I got to know you. You're funny. You're opinionated. And I like being with you. You never had any expectations of me. I could just be myself and relax. But I guess that's what love is. When you find that one person that frees you from all the BS life throws your way. I ask you to marry me because I want to wake up and feel that way every day for the rest of my life. Kira Jeffries, you're difficult and wonderful. Will you do me the honor of becoming my wife?
Are you sure? I was a real bitch.
I'll pay you back. Knowing you, pregnancy and childbirth will not be your finest hours.
Yes. Yes. I will marry you.
I wanted to let you all know I called the boat. It'll be here in an hour.
I know this hasn't been the most relaxing vacation that you were all hoping for. And so if any of you want to leave today, I will gladly comp your entire stay. Seriously, you shouldn't have to pay for something that is not up to par. And
actually, I'm having quite a wonderful time. I don't want to leave today.
Me neither.
Miss Laura, we don't want our money back. But we feel we do need to leave. I need to get my wife to a doctor. You see, we just found out that we're pregnant.
Oh!
Yeah, yes. Well, I mean, she's pregnant. Yes.
Pardon me, Reverend. This lovely young lady has agreed to be my wife.
Oh! Finally! Yes.
Congratulations.
That boy plays pro ball and he can't buy her a proper ring.
Oh, stop.
Now look, we really want a small wedding, okay? No press, no publicist, no bloggers, no fashion police. We just want to get married. Here, now, today.
Would you be able to do that for us before you leave?
Absolutely. I'd be on it. Yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, right now?
Of course not right now. The girl needs a dress. Yes. We have a wedding happening. Oh, my darling, come on.
Yes.
What do we do?
Well, let's meet back in an hour.
Oh, my God, we have 1 hour.
Let's go. Dress.
Yes. We've got to go. Come on. Come on.
We're
going
to have a bachelor party.
Oh, we've got to drive. Let's go.
There's nothing. There's nothing that I can wear that's remotely appropriate.
Oh, what about this?
Shorts. I can't get married in knickers.
She said you wanted white.
This is not working. This just isn't gonna happen.
No.
I can't do this.
No panicking, sweetheart. Here you go. Drink that. No fretting, sweetheart. Ladies, let's get creative. Okay, Freya.
Yeah.
Get me some toilet paper. Toilet paper.
On it.
She's gonna need a veil.
Yes. We'll use these flowers.
Laura, can I use this?
Yes, just take it down.
Oh, that's great.
This is fantastic. Toilet paper. It's toilet paper.
Mm-hmm.
That's toilet paper.
Yes, it is.
That's toilet paper. That's toilet paper. Okay. That's toilet paper.
Oh. Tears of joy come out. Beautiful. Slip into this. You are going to be such a beautiful bride. Oh, tears of joy. Tears of joy. Here you go. What is this? Let's go, my lovely. If we do the flowers in the veil, in the toilet paper.
Everyone knows that marriage is a covenant, an expression of love between two people and their God. But it's more than simply a union of love. It is a transformation of love. Marriage takes that tremendous love and affection from two people and transforms the individuals into something special, something stronger, something that renews itself with every hurdle, something that neither death nor sorrow can conquer. Raphael James Barrows, do you take Kira Martine Jeffries to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
And do you, Kira Martine Jeffries, take Raphael James Barrows to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the name of the one who makes us all whole, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Raphael Barrows. You may kiss your bride. Amen.
All right, who's ready? Who's ready for love?
Once again.
I don't really know.
No, not one of those.
You want some fruit?
Yeah, please, thank you so much. Hello,
sweetie. Oh, my God. I can smell these shrimp. I got it. I did. You call them
off. Well, what is up?
Abby would have loved this.
Yes, she would.
Jeffries could not be reached for comment. It is rumored that she may be in fashion.
Trolls. Hello?
Chuck, where are you?
If I wanted you to know, I would have told you, Chuck.
This is great. Who thought that Jock would propose? Kira, you are trending huge.
You think I know that?
You cannot disappear.
You want to bet on it? Want to get away from it all? Yes, yes, I do.
Thank you for coming, Jim.
I'll be coming out in a moment.
Did anyone recognize him?
No. To them, he was just...
another young black thug. I suppose I should be glad they didn't shoot him.
Naomi.
What's the charge?
Possession with intent to sell.
Drugs. Evan had drugs.
Yes. Look, it's his first offense, and I got him out, but Naomi... if this had happened next week when he turns 18, we'd be looking at something that not even a Holloway name would be able to fix.
Evan has early acceptance to Yale. If this gets out...
look, my suggestion, take him somewhere for a few days. Keep him out of the public eye while I clear this up with the DA.
Do what you can.
I want to thank you all for joining us this morning in the celebration of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm so glad he's back. It's his first sermon since their little girl passed.
I also want to thank you for the love and support that you've offered my wife and I during our period of grief and healing. Survival in this world is about faith. Every single day is about faith. Mm-hmm. It is said that faith is the silver that faith is the silver thread, is it is the pearl Abby.
Clinton.
People, it's time for some changes.
Those pelicans? Oh, how Abby would have loved this.
It's too cold on this side.
Is Abby your daughter? How old is she?
Six. She was six. Abby passed away 6 months ago. Leukemia.
I'm so sorry, my dear.
Thank you. My husband and I. Healing is hard.
People, it's time for some changes. People.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Île du Soleil, or Island of the Sun, as we non-French speakers like to call it. My name is Ray Tepper, and it is my job to make sure you are all safe and comfortable. Let's find out who we have with us today. Mr. and Mrs. Clinton Hines.
That's Reverend and Mrs. Hines.
Sorry, my bad. Welcome, Reverend. Ms. Alice Randolph. Ms. Alice Randolph?
No, that's my grandmother, Naomi Holloway, and I'm Evan Holloway.
All right, Holloways I got. Are you Alice Randolph?
Yes, that's me.
Very good, thank you. Everyone,